Metal.com. We're back.
We're back, baby.
Rockstar Cordova. We're doing this big. We got the Homeless One Productions Metal Fest here at the Norwalk Moose Lodge. I mean, out of all places.
Yeah, we're in Norwalk? Is that where the fuck we're at?
Metal venue, but you know what works? It's a big venue. We got two stages basically side by side. One's on this side, one's on this side. Pretty much the crowd just has to turn their head and they're keeping the bands going. I think there's like 150 bands over here today. I'm not sure. It seems like a lot.
A million.
So right here with me, out of all 150 bands that we're playing, of course we got the main, you know, Fallujah, Decrepit Bird, Warbringer, Antagonist, Caustic, you know, I got all these great bands that are gonna be playing. But out of all of them, the ones that really wanted to talk to me this is Harlequin from Los Angeles. Correct?
Yes.
So, why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself?
I'm Nato Maya. I'm the drummer for Harlequin.
I'm Rachel Solis. I'm the bassist at Becca Vocalist.
Excellent. And you guys got started when? I believe it's 2009 was the first year.
Yeah, 2009 is when both Tawny and I started jamming out. Tawny being our lead vocalist guitarist. And we just sort of built up from there, found our band members, and got going. So, been about 3-4 years.
So what was your you're pretty young though. How old are you?
We just look young.
How old are you?
No, I'm 22.
I'm
22. Yeah.
You're still young.
Come on. Yeah.
I'm almost 40. Come on.
What the fuck are you talking about? Estoy viejo. Que la chingada, cabrones.
So, alright, so you guys got started, so listen, 3 years ago, let me do my rock star math.
Oh, no.
You guys were like 12, right? No. Something, I'm not sure.
No, just fresh out of high school, so we were all like 18, 19.
Okay, yeah. So how long did you, alright, so let's get a little background on your musicianship. How long have you individually been playing your instruments?
Well, I started playing bass in high school in a jazz band.
Yeah, jazz band.
They needed a bass player, and I was like,
all right,
I'm down.
Yeah.
So, like, since 2004.
Okay, and you?
I just started playing drums as soon as I decided to be in a band. I was just like, oh, because I used to be in high school, there was these girls trying to start up a band, and they were like, oh, we need a drummer, and I was like, hey, I think I could do it. And that's how I picked it up. But previously, I had experience with music. I'd played piano, violin, so I figured, hey, why not try drums? I pretty much started drumming for Harlequin.
Yeah, so we got jazz influence, we got everything else.
Everything else.
How did you guys gravitate toward, I mean, typically when you think about a typical metalhead, they're jamming away to like Metallica and Slayer and everything that we grew up with, and all obviously the new bands now, with the new generation, and that's their influences. That's what they get experienced with because that's what they want to play. But you guys started in a completely different genre. But so were you guys always metalheads or?
I think that's how it worked out. I mean, I think it would be safe to say for all of us that we always had a love for music, all kinds of music, not just metal. And just like you, we grew up, well, at least I did. I also grew up listening to Metallica, classic rock, you know, fucking Slayer, you know, that's what was the shit for me, at least in high school, you know. And the more we grew, the more we started paying attention to the current metal coming out. And, you know, I guess that all that played a role in influence us music-wise. So, I mean, we never, when we started the band, we never went to the route of immediately going for covers. We immediately just started writing our own stuff. So when she came in, she obviously had an influence. Because Tawny's more like a, I guess I would say more black metal influence. I came more from the thrash side. She added her own jazz improv kind of stuff, you know. So it's like all of us had a big piece to put into the band.
Thank you.
Thank you guys.
Four piece band, by the way. Yeah. Two members are.
Tony and Chris are not here. Yeah. They're on their way.
Suckers.
It's a long show. So.
So you guys started in 2009, not too long ago. So are you finding that your time in the business, you just started, obviously. So what's it like for females, and what can you offer as advice for maybe other females who are watching this right now and want to get into it, or maybe you're afraid because of all the testosterone that's around? I mean, we got bands.
Definitely.
I mean, you know, we came up in the 90s, a band called Kitty, who's all you know, from Canada, all four girls, you know, heavy metal, just obliterated a lot of the male bands. And I think they paved the way, I think, for a lot of the newer generation, like you girls. What would you say, what was your encounter first with coming in as an all-female group and dealing with all these metalheads? I'm sure they're probably, you know.
Honestly, I don't even think it was supposed to be all girls. It just happened.
Yeah, we weren't like, oh, we're going to start an all-girl metal band. No, it was just like, hey, I feel comfortable with you, probably because we're both females. Let's jam out. All right, hey, another female. She knows how to play too. Sure, all right. You know, like, it wasn't like, oh, we're just looking for... We actually, Tanya and I actually had a couple of guy bassists before that we were just jamming out with. So, I mean... It wasn't strictly like,
I mean, for any girls out there that want to play, just do it. I mean, of course you're going to get mistreated. That's what happens. I mean, we've had a lot of like occasions where we were like mistreated because we were girls. Or a lot of people would come up to us and be like, oh, you guys, we at first when we were like, oh, no, girl band, you guys, we thought you guys were just, you know, just a show. Or,
yeah.
And then when they heard us, they're like, oh, wow, you guys can actually play. You know?
So what kind of mistreatments were you guys?
It was like, I don't know, it was just like when we first started out, there weren't a lot of girl bands, as there are now. There's a lot popping out now, especially in the metal scene. There's like girls left and right, I'm so surprised. But like, when we first started out, we were just playing like, you know, backyard gigs in South Central, LA. And just a lot of, you know, they were just being disrespectful. Yeah, yeah. So just not really being polite, you know, and just sort of thinking we're there more for the show versus like there for the music. So and also too, sometimes we get booked for shows and people just kind of think, oh, they don't know what's up, so we're just gonna stick them in the shittiest slot and just not even give them a share of the pay and stuff like that, you know. But for all the girls out there, that if you love music, man, and if you think you want to play, pick up that guitar, pick up those drumsticks and just fucking do it. And like, don't let anyone push you around. There's gonna be a lot of people putting you down, telling you that you can't do it or that you suck. But you know what? In the end, it doesn't matter if you are male, female. Like, you learn by practice and practice and practice. And that's the bottom line. Like, don't ever let anyone tell you like that you suck, especially because you're a girl that has nothing to do with it. Trust me, like, we are capable of playing instruments. And especially in metal, we can get aggressive. We have aggressive sides too, so.
All right, yeah. So you guys had quite an experience. Anything that you can give go do it, you know, yeah. But is there any kind of particular tips that maybe you can keep girls away in terms of like business, booking,
most definitely. It's a problem that we encounter even with the male bands, you know, it doesn't matter. It's just be organized, be on top of stuff. When you want to get on a show, just go out there, talk to promoters, get on it. Be organized with your shows and always present yourself very professional, very businesslike. Talk to people, network, you know, that's the way to do it. And that's with any band, male or female. Like, I think that's the best tip I could give, because there's a lot of bands out there that are trying to get out there, trying to get something going, but they're not organizing their shows, they're not presenting themselves well, and people want to see that you have your I don't know if I can cuss.
Yes, you can fucking cuss. This ain't PG show.
Yeah, but pretty much people want to know that you have your shit going on and that you know what's up and that you're ready to go, you're a serious musician and that you're ready to go and play a show. So, I mean, I think that's the best thing to do. Like,
awesome. So, now when you started, did you guys get a demo together and shop with that, or did you just go straight into putting a full length out? Where did you guys go in terms of writing?
Writing, we went ahead and wrote our demo, but we don't have any with us.
I do have one actually.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Do now. Awesome. Well, yeah, let's show that for the camera.
They're not like the nice ones we used to have. They're like the ghetto ones.
The ghetto ones.
If anything, you can find it online, facebook.com/harlequinofficial. We have our SoundCloud link, our YouTube. You can find all our songs on there. But yeah, we went ahead and started with this demo.
We actually have nice covers and everything.
It's a demo.
Yeah,
can you
we
tell?
Have nice covers.
This way, there we go. Harlequin official.
Yeah. Hey, it's still a CD though.
Facebook.com.
Yeah. We used to have those cassette tapes and shit.
So and then right now we're currently working on writing the music for our full length album. So.
Okay, do you have a recording studio set up, or are you guys doing your own recording, or do you...
We did our recording, our demo recording with Juan
Executor Studios, but now we're doing it with Will. I guess he's a teacher at a recording school in Hollywood, and he's going to help us out with recording our newest song.
Uh-huh. And then after that, come on. From there, we'll see what's up.
Awesome. And in terms of what you guys are going to be doing next, are you guys have a tour plan, or are you just going to be... kind of staying in SoCal and doing a bunch of dates?
Oh no, we have big things planned for us. All this month actually, we have a lot of shows lined up, and we're actually going to Texas at the end of the month. From there, I know September we're going to Arizona. So I mean, our plan pretty much right now is to finish up our new album and just get out there. I mean, anywhere we go. A month ago we went to Santa Barbara. So I mean, we're trying to reach out of LA. Because we've been here for a while. Yeah. So, I mean, just try to get fans out there.
So where's the farthest you've been out so far?
Ooh, just Santa Barbara.
Santa Barbara. Okay, so are you being received well by the LA fans? I mean, when you talk about LA, I mean, it's an inundation of metal. Yeah. You know, and there's thousands of bands and thousands of venues to play at. So are you guys standing out? Are you finding that your fan base is growing or staying stagnant? Are you guys...
No, I definitely feel since we come out, we have our collection of fans, people know of us. We definitely had no problem getting our name out there. That was like luck, you know, but definitely the LA crowd, I guess it's just a little bit hard to get to, I think for any band, not just us, because there's so much music out here, bands left and right, you see them all day, every day, there's shows every day of the week, like it's not hard to catch a live band if you want to. Versus like if you go anywhere else, you know, it's not like that, you know. So the crowd here, I mean, it's great. This is where you get all the pins and you get people go crazy and you travel, you know. I think it's a little bit easier to stand out for any band when you travel because it's like they don't see that kind of music every day. They don't see those bands every day. And they're generally excited. Oh my gosh, you know, they're not, yeah. Yeah.
expect out of a Harlequin show?
Expect excitement.
Is there anything particular about your show?
Like, we are influenced by different kinds of music. We like black metal, we like the slam, death, brutal death metal, and we like everything. Just expect the unexpected, I guess. You know, honestly,
unexpected.
Like, we play what we are influenced by at the moment.
Yeah,
and LA, true. I guess that's the good thing about LA, gives us that opportunity to listen to different kind of.
Well, all right. Well, let's wrap this up. We're gonna have, you know, on the bottom, we're gonna toss in your .coms and everything,
awesome,
and links and everything.
Awesome,
so, any kind of last thing that you want to get out there, tell, promote.
You
got sponsors, management.
If you want to sponsor us, please.
No sponsors yet. All right, they're available.
All right,
you're
not sponsored yet, but we're working hard. We've got great stuff coming up, so just keep an eye out. Like we said, facebook.com/harlequinofficial, and we're coming to a city near you.
All right, and the last thing, you know, it's horns up, metal sleeve. Let's give up your best horns
right,
up. Thank you, ladies.
Yeah.
And see you next time in the pit.
All right.